Could you please let me go first? No? Serious? Should've turned. Anyways, I cannot change what's been done already. Let's go forward now. This is stupid, man! When I can get you out of my... out of my... what is going on, ladies and gentlemen? Tempest with you today. We're going to be playing American Truck Simulator. Yes, I know. I told you last time we're not going to be playing it, but then, well, I got intrigued and ended up buying. Anyways, today we're going to be trying it out, and I'm really, really interested what the difference is going to be between American Truck Simulator and the Euro Truck Simulator, basically. You can see here, oh my god, I cannot see anything due to this pipe. Jesus Christ, it's a huge truck. Anyways, you can see I've started a new career here, and we are going to be delivering our first cargo of office supplies. Yes. Oh, wait a second. Where does it say my gear? Oh, it doesn't say anything here. Ah, there it goes. Finally, we can go forward. I chose my standard default truck design as Kenworth. Kenworth, as I believe it is the most beautiful truck in existence of humanity, and we're gonna be driving it now. Exactly. Although the trip is real short, I didn't know how loud this is for you boys. We're gonna be delivering it in 9 minutes. No time. I kinda hoped we could drive it for longer periods of time. Anyways, this episode is gonna be not only comparison episode between Euro Truck Simulator and American Truck Simulator, but it also gonna be the start of a new career. Hopefully, we can make it. You can see my hometown is Los Angeles, yes, exactly where I live, and we're gonna be going to Los Angeles, basically. We're gonna be delivering our cargo within the city. I can already see that cities in American Truck Simulator are more detailed. As you can see here, we kind of have more details. Yes, I said it already. And I like it. I like that they've put more effort into developing proper cities. Although I know that we can turn right in US while red signal is on. So that's exactly what I'm gonna be doing. Come on. I gotta go. Yes! What's the power of this truck? I'd say no more than 400 horsepower. Although American trucks have more horsepower, doesn't mean they're more efficient than Euro truck. European trucks. Yes, doesn't mean like at all. One huge disadvantage of this game is that they don't have many trucks. Yes, I mean truck manufacturers. Let me quickly see just how many of them. How do we do that? I'm gonna be adjusting my seat. Exactly what I had to do in the first place before I even started the game, but I'm gonna be trying it anyway. So, like so. No, this I'm gonna leave standard. Anyways, 7 minutes till our destination. Hopefully I won't get any tickets in the beginning. We don't need that. I don't think we have any money whatsoever. No, we have 1,500. And so far I see that graphics in this game aren't much different from... Oh, look at that. This looks beautiful. Loving it. Yeah, the graphics aren't much different from Euro Truck Simulator's graphic, but I can already see the difference in traffic though. Traffic is gonna be insane in this game. Well, considering we are driving across Los Angeles, this is realistic. Although one thing I didn't really like about it is, yes, US is a huge territory. There are lots of things to see, but still, it's not gonna be as diverse as Europe. First of all, and second of all, there are only 3 states, I assume, in this game. Oh my God, and of course there are gonna be miles. I'm gonna be living this game in miles, obviously. I'm not gonna be going kilometers per hour, because every signal here, every sign here is in miles, of course. That is exactly what I'm gonna be doing. Let's see, 78 degrees outside, which is a very, very warm, pleasant weather. Okay, careful, careful. Look at the gear shifting here. D12 I saw for a second, D5. All right, water temperature, What else do we have here? I see oil temperature. I see RPM air, or whatever that means. I know that lots of... Oh, wait a second. Go forward, mate. Oh my god, I'm screwing this up already. I'm sorry, guys, behind me. I was trying to do this as fast, but I screwed up a little bit with the neutral shift. Thank you very much for not bumping into me, though. Really appreciate it, boys. What about our cargo right now? We still have 4 hours to deliver this. I might as well sleep and just enjoy the whole game here. Let's see. I'd say that Los Angeles looks very authentic, considering I live here myself. I recognize places, especially the downtown district looks very, very real. I'm not sure how realistic, well, the rest of the streets are. So we're going to be assessing that in this episode. Not going to be traveling across Los Angeles whole episode, though. Okay. Stop! Yeah, it's weird. It's weird how similar this is to Los Angeles, really. Oh my god, I think I gotta adjust my seat again, because it's not very, very convenient. This is much better. Although, view is a little bit obstructed still, I might adjust it after I complete my recording. Hopefully it is recording, goddammit. Yeah, one major disadvantage I noticed so far is that we don't have as many truck manufacturers. I know I already said it, but I really hope they're gonna be adding more DLCs. This game's been out for what? How long already? I'd say almost a year now? Maybe even more? And I expect some major changes. Like, they should add more truck manufacturers, because Kenworth and Peterbilt won't cut it. Although I have no idea how many there are in this game. But according to the pictures I saw, videos I saw, there are only 3 or 4 varieties max. And I don't really like the modern looking American trucks. They look crappy and plastic, almost like Chinese kind of trucks. These steel monsters look so much better, like this Kenworth here. I think there is one Peterbilt looking almost exactly the same here. Anyways, what about our traffic? Wow, it's taking a while to get there. That's what I call in-town driving. In-town driving is ruthless. There we go. Come on. Yeah, my trailer is kind of long. I'll admit that. I know there are immensely long ones. Chevron! We have Chevron here. Let's remember this moment, guys, here. Chevron is epic. I think I'm going to be downloading realistic gas stations, as well as real life companies. Well, for the trailer, basically. I'm going to be downloading that too, because it's going to add so much to the game. But we're going to be doing that in the next episode. In case I enjoy this game so much, I want to play. Oh, of course! I'm so sorry, mate. This is my fault. Complete. And please don't bump. Careful. I think I'm okay. I think I'm doing just fine. I'm real sorry that was so close. Alright. Was he trying to reverse? I think he was trying to reverse. That's epic! Okay, we are almost there. What about our weather? Weather is amazing. Also, I'd really love to read patch notes and see. I already see there is more pedestrians here, rather than comparing it to Euro Truck Simulator. And cities are, well, at least Los Angeles is. God damn it! Of course I missed it. Well, let's try from another entrance then. Right turn, red signal, who cares? You're gonna be fining us for this. Doing everything right. Right signal. Don't tell me they're gonna be fining me for this. Although I wonder how well bot is gonna be distinguishing my right turns during red signal. Is it even gonna work? Okay, so I think I managed to deliver my office supplies, although not quite sure whether I've entered these premises right. It's gonna be fine. Let's adjust our truck. Hello, everybody. You need office supplies here? I think they do. I think they'd appreciate that. Okay, I'm going real slow. So I don't want to be bumping into anything. That's how I drive in real life. I'm lame like that, yes. Okay, we're gonna be just skipping it. I don't see the point of parking it, because considering we've already spent 30 minutes getting here in the first place. Yes, thank you very much. 460. And it's gonna take us forever to level up. Yes, let's see, what else can we do? We got our garage, truck headquarters in LA. Yes, something to celebrate, although we have no money whatsoever. Good luck. I think we gotta complete couple more jobs before we can afford truck dealers. Nothing is available, as you can see. We're gonna still go to the job market, choose the quick job, and well, basically, take a look at what is available. Here, let's see, let's take a look at the trucks that are available. This one is the Kenworth, the Peterbilt, the Kenworth, and the Kenworth. Are there only two truck manufacturers in series? Kenworth, Peterbilt. Oh my god, there are only two, really? Oh my god, I overestimated this crap. Yeah, that is the exact reason why I never wanted to buy American Truck Simulator, because, there are minimal choices in this game. The only reason I really got it is due to the environments, really. Just to look how different it is from Euro Truck, whether it has potential to be played, etc, etc. Here, let's start sorting it, price per distance. I think that is best for now. So, there is this Kenworth here that requires us to deliver a pressure tank, 42,000 pounds, to Santa Maria, California. That is exactly what I'm gonna be doing, I think. Yes, let's do that. Take the job. Oh my god, this is real loud. Music is real loud. I don't know how it's gonna work with the recording. Let's take a look at our pressure tank. Alright, we have 4 hours and 39 minutes to deliver this cargo. No, not really. 9 hours to deliver this cargo. We'll be starting this engine here. Oh my god. No, not that. Let's admire our truck. Looks amazing. Yes. This is one reason why I like this game. Anyways, not saying this is a complete crap game. Of course, it's an amazing game still. Very like Euro Truck Simulator. But again, I like diversity. And this is something this game kind of lacks. Still, you can see here, we have Nevada, California, Arizona, and that is it. Don't see anything else here. Might be wrong though. Yeah, I'd love to see the rest of the US, although I don't think that's gonna be very much different. And that is exactly why, again, I like Euro Truck Simulator so much more. Let's give this game a chance anyways. We're gonna be trying it. Let's see how beautiful environments are really. Alright, Kenworth, you ready? Yes, I think my Kenworth is ready. What about... No, don't go backwards. What about interiors here? Oh my god, I have my own cut in there. Loving the interior size here. Yeah, American trucks are so much bigger than European ones. But that is also a major disadvantage. That is not as easy to maneuver them as you might have seen. I almost bumped inside LA already. Hopefully we can make it to the highway soon, just to see how well detailed are those highways. Alright, oh my god, I love this car. I love the car. Let's turn right. Pressure tank. What's the weight of it though? Alright, it's 42,000 pounds. Going to Santa Maria. What is the speed limit? 55 miles per hour. Miles per hour, really? Hello, Range Rover. Go on, mate. Hello, Kenworth. Please pass us by as fast as possible. Thank you very much. Is there Kamaz or... Oh my god, I'm seeing things already. Seeing things. Alrighty, this looks lame. My turn was epic, but I made it anyways. 98 degrees now. How is it even possible? You serious? From 78 to 98 in a matter of hours? Oh my gosh. This is crazy. Bar. This truck has 59,050 miles. Yeah, it's kinda lot of miles. Not merely enough though. Almost brand new, considering trucks can drive so much more. Look at this. And hull. I love the traffic diversity though. It's very different from Euro Truck. You can already see it. But I'd really love somehow they could, well, I don't know, maybe merge these two games. Like for example, let's have this weird, crazy idea of merging Euro Truck Simulator and American Truck Simulator. For example, you've had enough. Oh my god, I thought I bumped already. Let's say you have driven enough in Europe. You want to drive across America or vice versa. For that, you gotta pay, for example, a fixed fee of, let's say, 20,000 euros or dollars, and you could change your location. That'd be amazing. Let's propose that to the developers. Please create World of Trucks, really, not separate continents. I'd really appreciate it. I'd really love US as the, well, as the DLC to Euro Truck, not the other way around. Not for it to be a standalone game. As I said, it still lacks a lot of things it should have had in the first place. To me, it feels like I wouldn't say incomplete game. No, not really, not an incomplete game. But comparing it to Euro Truck Simulator, again, I'm comparing it to Euro Truck Simulator, feels kind of, how should I say it better? I don't know. Feel like I must say incomplete. Yeah, feels like there isn't enough choice. And then again, I really admire these highways. They look very authentic. I'm loving what I see so far. Roads are very wide. I see nature being okay. And well, still, Euro Truck Simulator is more beautiful. I prefer that game to American Truck Simulator still. But then again, it's only, what, how long am I playing this? 20 minutes? Oh my god. Oh my god, we're driving too fast here. Please do not fine us. Please do not fine us. Then again, I'm just playing this game for 20 minutes, so I cannot judge really. And if only this game had, well, at least a couple more truck manufacturers. I don't ask for a lot. I ask for at least 2-3 more. That'd be amazing. That'd be complete different story for me. I'd be like, well, it's not as good as Euro Truck Simulator, of course, but it's still great game. Now, no, I wouldn't recommend it to you boys. I wouldn't recommend it yet. Again, still trying to assess it. I have no right to say anything bad about this game. I understand it. I'm still playing it for mere minutes, for a couple of minutes. But then again, still my current reflection, my current thoughts. Why are we going so slow? 53 miles per hour, it's not that slow. It's kind of fast, but it feels so much slower for some reason. Again, comparing it to Euro Truck. There aren't as many DLCs, as I told you, so therefore we are lacking paid jobs, we are lacking different cargoes, we are lacking we're lacking a bunch of things, basically. I forgot what I was gonna say, boys, but I'm gonna come up with it again. Yeah, cargoes, of course, I said it already. And aren't as diverse, but then again, this game is relatively new comparison to Euro Truck Simulator, so I won't be judging it too harsh. Again, not gonna be judging it too harsh. It has its right to exist, of course. There are a bunch of fans who prefer this game to Euro Truck Simulator, I'm sure, but I'm just expressing my opinion, nobody else's. It's my opinion only. Don't judge me too harsh, boys. Alrighty, I think we're still within Los Angeles, if not mistaken. Gonna be leaving it pretty soon. Graphics? What about graphic presets here? Let me quickly go into options, I just wanna see. Doesn't look as nice for some reason, I might be fucking things up here. Yes, it's 4K, refresh rate shouldn't be no more than 60. vertical sync. I don't really care about it. So let's try and apply this. Are you serious? Oh my god. Yes. Save. Custom settings applied. What are custom settings? Let's take a look at it. Alright. Anti-aliasing. We don't need that. It's dumb. I think I'm gonna be trying scaling here, although not really. Reflection detail. Everything is set to high or ultra. What about drawing distance? Can we see drawing distance here? I don't see drawing distance though. Jesus Christ. Alright, not gonna be wasting your... God damn it. Not gonna be wasting your time here, boys, anymore. Let me quickly exit the settings and return into the game. Okay, Oh, whoa, wait a sec. Where is traffic now? Where am I now? Jesus. I'm lost. Lost. Santa Maria, Santa Cruz. 2 hours and 53 minutes. We're gonna... By the way, completely forgot to check the mail. We got a new mail. I think it should be from the bank. Brand new Kenworth trucks for sale. We are a certified retailer of Kenworth trucks. We offer a wide selection of different configurations and we can also perform customizations, blah 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 blah. We already know that. Let me quickly see what is actually... Alright, trusted customers only. Trusted customers only for online purchasing. Well, you're gonna regret that. I cannot actually see what is in there. Alright, Oxnard up ahead. And we are driving too fast for some reason. Please reduce your speed. I think I have cruise control set up, although... Yeah, it should be set up. Why doesn't it break? Cruise control should decrease speed too. Jesus Christ. What's wrong with this truck? Santa Maria. 103 miles. Yeah, let me quickly look around here. Feel like... It looks gorgeous. And there is something lacking about... graphics in this game. I cannot quite see what is lacking. Let me think about it. It might be due to my graphics settings not being perfected yet. Might be not. Wait. I need to take... No, I'm heading in the right direction. I'm sorry, boys. I'm sorry, boys, for this crazy truck on the road. Are you next to me? No, he's not. Let's change lane here. Right lane. Oh my god, this is looking crazy, but effective nevertheless. Man, this truck feels very powerful. Just want to see how many horsepowers. Let's see, 454 horsepower, which is more than what my Mercedes has at the moment. And 340 kilowatts. Huh, feels very powerful. Again, this is around, 44,000 pounds, which is roughly... I'd say 19 tons. Yeah, roughly that. Why is it so heavy though? This pressure tank is kind of heavy. Serious? Doesn't look as heavy though. I think I'm gonna be taking a screenshot. It's gonna allow me a photo mode. Wait a second here. Quick screenshot. I hope you will understand, boys. Really like taking these kind of screenshots. Yes, it looks beautiful. It looks amazing. And we're going to be taking it quickly right here. Bam! There we go. Screenshot done. Continue our journey, please. Drive. Yeah, 77 miles left. And it feels like they are underpaid. $5,000 for this journey. I'd expect... Well, I'm still an experienced driver. Relatively an experienced driver in this game. So that could be the reason. It's neat, that indicator of trip distance on my dashboard over there. 106 miles driven. Trip economy D13. What does it even mean? I think that's the way my engine is pre-set up here. There are lots of features in this game that are not still in Euro Truck Simulator, but they are going to be adding those features to the Euro Truck Simulator pretty soon. Therefore, Euro Truck Simulator is going to be better than American Truck Simulator again. Yes, in every aspect of it. I think there must be features like like trailer braking system. It's already being implemented in American Truck Simulator, still not in Euro Truck Simulator. There are cops that are going to be added to Euro Truck Simulator pretty soon. I'm not sure whether they are in American Truck Simulator, but I assume they are. I think so. Might be completely wrong though. What else? Engine braking system was there since beginning of times. What else? I think there is something else being added, but I completely forgot. Oh my god, look at that train appearing from nowhere. You serious? What is wrong? I think something is wrong with my drawing distance. I gotta fix that. My frame rate is very stable though, 60 frames per second. So I think I can afford increasing settings in here. Drawing distance in particular would be nice to see. Again, I'm kind of stumbled trying to express my feelings about this game. I have mixed feelings. I like detailing and I don't like diversity. That pretty much sums it up. I'd love to see more more choice again. But great thing about this particular game is that there are lots of details. Like for example, you can see there are lots of mini towns. The cities are much bigger than in Euro Truck Simulator. Although I think there's been this add-on to Euro Truck Simulator that adds a couple of cities. I haven't checked that out yet, but in comparison to American Truck Simulator, Euro Truck Simulator is lacking those in-city highways, in-city streets and traffic. Also, what else can I see from here? Also, it lacks powerful tractors like this one, Kenworth. I'd love to drive it within Europe, of course. And well, American Truck Simulator lacks everything else basically. Therefore, I'd love to see those games combined. Again, I said it already, but I'd really love to see them combined. What else can we highlight here? There are cops here. I see them. I'm not sure whether they are functional. You know what? I don't feel like testing them. But considering they are here and I can see them, I think we can safely assume they are functional. They are gonna be stopping me if I go too fast or start bumping or crazy into everything that moves. Feels like the case. 5.2 miles per gallon. That's efficiency, boys. That is a true efficiency. My truck in comparison can do twice that. Well, three times this much on a highway. Yeah, still, it's a lot. 5.3 miles per gallon, it's crazy much. Trip economy, it's set to economy and it's 5.3 miles per gallon. God damn it. It's crazy, crazy much. Let me see, what else can we do here? I think we gotta take right. Nope, we gotta go forward. Santa Maria is on the right. Although that is not exactly where we're heading. It's close though. I think I gotta visit Santa Maria this time though, just to explore, open up goodies, open up that truck manufacturer, whatever that W means. I wonder. Gonna be turning right soon. Better prepare for it. There we go. Santa Maria, exit now please. I'd really appreciate it. Oh my god, look at that brake pressure. It's neat. Look at the thing jumping up. I'm loving it. Brake pressure. Still have a bunch of buttons I haven't assigned yet. And I don't believe I'll ever be able to assign it on my joystick. Although, I might be wrong, I might use combination of buttons to be able to assign things like engine brake, a trailer brake, and a bunch of buttons that are still assigned, well, just for my keyboard. Let me concentrate here for a second. Left, right, and up! There we go. Wait a sec. Almost bumped into this beautiful Kenwood. Could you please let me go first? No? Serious? Serious? I should have... Oh! Alright. Never mind that. Wait a second. Alright, now we can go back. Oh my god! Jesus! I hate these truck drivers. Like myself here. Bumping into every living thing. There's a freaking traffic jam now. Oh my god, this is so pathetic. I think I damaged my cargo. Does it say here whether it did or not? Let me quickly check. Doesn't say here. F8. No, there are no short messages. Anyways, I cannot change what's been done already. Let's go forward now. This is stupid, man. This is stupid. How many drugs are here? You serious? This journey is taking forever, man. Turn already. Turn. Can you please let me go? Traffic is incredible in this game. There are too many cars for my liking. 50% off on apples. I'm loving that. Let me quickly stop here and eat a bit of apples. But that's been crazy. Oh my god, that thing bumped into me. God damn it. Not that I bumped into that thing like an idiot. For some reason, assumed there are no cars behind me. What an idiot I am, in fact. So we are delivering pressure tank to the sort of a farm here. Yes, why would you need pressure tank, ladies and gentlemen? I have no idea why. But we're gonna be turning left here. Yes. Stop. There is a slightly damaged but still in a very good condition pressure tank for you boys. Let me park it myself. Because I like parking. Yes, I love it. It's my favorite thing to do. Oh, there is some sort of a mechanic over there. Hello, buddy. He's fixing cedar. I'm loving it. These kind of details making this game amazing. Yes, they are making this. Wait a second. How am I supposed to turn here? There isn't enough space. Are you kidding me? Wait a sec. Let me quickly assess the situation. Yeah. Oh my god. This is going to be a tough one. This is going to be a tough one. But we're going to make it. There we go. Let's go. Hopefully I can make it, boys. Hopefully I can. Again, I'm still not good at first person perspective. Here, I would fail miserably. This is kind of a hard parking thing. I think I gotta go to the left first. A little bit. Before we start. I'm gonna shut up for a second. Gotta concentrate, boys. Sorry for that. This is gonna test all my skills in parking. Okay. Looks okay. It looks good so far. Okay, looks better now. Looks better. Just a little bit to the right still. More. Oh my god, this is so bad. This is so bad, mate. Yep, gotta fix that. Go forward, Kenwood. This is gonna be okay now. I believe I can... Wait a sec, that's the wrong approach. You see? This is gonna work now. Yes. This is painful parking. A painful parking tutorial. 2.0. Yeah, I don't have enough space, really. Simply doesn't allow me. Although I'm sure you guys would have been able to do that. I'm lacking skills for this. Like, surely I am. Anyway, skip the parking then. God damn it, failed miserably. Anyways, let's see. What do we get here? 287 experience. Which made us level 2. We are newbie. Yes, exactly what I am, in fact. And I think I'm gonna go for... Deliveries up to 400 miles, which is already more than in Euro Truck Simulator. Yes, or fragile. What should we go for? What do you think? We should go for hazardous cargo or long distance? That is gonna depend. Well, whatever you are gonna propose, boys, whatever you think is gonna be better. But I'm gonna end this episode here. Still don't have conclusions for this game. Don't know whether I should call it worse than a Euro Truck Simulator. Again, I'm going to be playing a couple more episodes just to feel the game, see what it's all about. And yeah, thanks for watching. And leave the videos now tomorrow, boys. Bye-bye.